One of my favorite things about analog heat is the fact that since we have it as a VST, it's very easy to automate parameters. I'm using Ableton Live as my DAW, and if I want to automate certain things with an analog heat, I can simply use a clip envelope, or I can do automation on the track if it's in the arrangement view, and I can make these things do whatever I want. So I'm going to start playing around with the filter. I have a nice little bass sound here that I'd like to get some filter modulation happening on. But before I do that, I want to point out something else. I have my analog heat here, and this is receiving clock from Ableton Live. And I'm able to take the clock that's being received by analog heat and send that out to another device. And I happen to have my SP404 right here, the little hi-hat pattern that I think I want to add. So let me start playing this. The hi-hat sound that we're hearing right now is coming from my SP404. And one of the main things I wanted to do was maybe put a little effect on here, manipulate that in real time, and be able to record that to a clip before I start playing with my bass. Now, the reason why this is syncing to Ableton Live is because if I go into the settings for analog heat, on the left side over here, we see the options for the internal tempo, and the tempo here matches the tempo of my DAW because we're receiving clock. I can see that I'm receiving clock is where it says MIDI sync. We have MIDI clock receive, and that's enabled. My SP404 is getting clock from heat because where it says MIDI clock send, that's also enabled. This is a good way to get sync from our DAW sent out to external hardware. With that said, I'm going to quickly record a little clip because heat is also my interface, my audio interface. And I have an audio track right here set up to receive input from channels 1 and 2. So I'll record a little hi-hat clip before I start playing with my bass. Let's go ahead and start recording here. I'll double click on the clip so you can see the audio coming in. All right, I think that's good enough for now. So now I can turn this down. Unmute this track. Oh, well, let's go ahead and solo that. There we go. All right, so I've got the hi-hat that I recorded, and now I want to focus on this bass sound. So let's go back to our preset editor here. Analog heat is on this bass track. And like I said, I want to be able to manipulate the filter frequency in some sort of unique way. If we look at the filters over here, we have a bunch of different filter types. Let me go ahead and adjust the filter cutoff frequency so we can see the curves a bit better. Alright, so our first filter type is a low-pass filter. And you can see we have two low-pass filters. The first one has a steeper slope than the second one. So depending on how much of the frequency spectrum you want to isolate, you have some options there. The next option is a band-pass filter. And I think this will be a nice option to utilize if I can blend this with the dry signal. But I'll get back to that. Next to that, we have two different high-pass filters. Again, the first one has a more gradual slope. The one next to that has a more steep slope. We also have a band reject filter or a notch filter, whatever you prefer. Giving this some movement can be a really nice way to do some filter phase sort of sound. And we also have our peak filter over here. This can be really useful in tandem with the two low and high EQ to give us more of a three-band EQ. Also, giving this some movement can be really nice too. But like I said, I'm going to focus on the bandpass filter. So let me select this. I'm going to change the distortion circuit to saturation. Give us a good amount of drive here. Let's go ahead and mute the hi-hat so we can just focus on what's happening with this bass. So again, I want to give this some movement, some modulation. And I'm going to use a clip envelope to do so. If we look down here, when you bring analog heat into Ableton Live, at the bottom of the screen, you get this very generic looking GUI. But if I expand it, hitting this triangle, I can see every parameter inside of analog heat, which means that these are all available to be modulated using clip envelopes or for basic track automation. My filter frequency is here, and I'm touching this so that when I go to my clip envelope, the last thing I touch is what shows up in the chooser boxes there. So let me switch over to my clip view. My envelope is visible. It's visible because I hit my E button down here to show it. And the last thing I touched was analog heat and the filter frequency. Now, I'd like to make some sort of filter movement that happens over the course of maybe just one bar. This is a pretty long clip, but I don't need to automate this throughout the duration of the entire clip. So I'm going to unlink my clip envelope here. I'll make this one bar long. And let's zoom in here, and let's give our filter some movement. I will add a few breakpoints here on the quarter notes. And I'm simply going to make the filter cutoff value increase every other beat. So let me grab this guy here. And let me grab grab this one here. Nice. Now I think the filter cutoff is a little bit too high. I like the movement, but I think the frequency is a bit too high. So I'm gonna highlight this entire envelope and just bring the overall level down. There we go. Nice, okay. Now again, it's a bit extreme for my taste, but we can blend this. We can also adjust the wet level independently. So let me go ahead and just bring the wet level down a bit. Nice. Now again, I really appreciate what we're doing. You should hear this with heat bypassed and then hear it with all our cool little tricks that we've enabled. So let me go ahead and make this inactive. And we'll activate it. Nice, so we got some nice rhythmic movement there. We've been able to tame it so it's not too extreme. Now in addition to this, we see to the right of the filter, we have an LFO here. This LFO is great, it's very flexible, but it doesn't reach every single parameter within analog heat. But again, we're using a DAW, which gives us a lot more options. Before analog heat, I brought in a Max4Live LFO. Just double click right here so we can see it. And I can use this LFO to modulate any parameter that Heat's LFO can't access. For example, if we look, the very first parameter I have here is the circuit type. And I can use this to switch between the different circuits. And I can map my Max4Live LFO to modulate this. So let me go ahead and hit my map button, map it to the circuit type. I love just seeing this dance. It's like the visual feedback is extremely nice. But more importantly, this gives you a good idea of what's actually happening. I think this might be moving a little bit too quick, so I'm going to change the sync rate to a bar. There we go. Nice. So again, we've been able to add some nice character to this bass sound. And if I unsolo this track, you can hear it in context.